Welcome back to part two of Good Morning Pattaya, Pattaya Channel's very own breakfast show. I'm still Nick Pendrell, but this gentleman here is...
Jason.
Welcome back, Jason.
Pleasure to be here.
Good to see you back here. Are you ready to see a few more videos?
I would love to see the videos. I love the ones you choose, so bring it on.
Okay. Well, one of the things that I hate is anything motivational, those stupid posters that you get in office going, be all you can be, and stuff like that. And the ones on video are even worse. So I really enjoy it when some go wrong. And this particular one went wrong in a very big way.
Hello, friends. I wanted to make a video to hopefully inspire you to do something that you may feel is too difficult. You can do anything that you think that you can do. You just need to believe in yourself, formulate a plan of action, and follow through with it. Like this piece of wood here. In a few moments, I'm going to break it over my head. First, you need to believe in yourself. Believe that you can do what you set out to do. Then you need to figure out how it is you're going to go about doing what you want to do, and follow through with it. Now, it may be convenient to blame your failure on external factors, but really the failure to do anything is your own fault. It's not anybody else's fault. It's yours for not coming up with a suitable alternative, or for giving up, or something. So, without further ado, I'm going to break this thing over my head. Okay, didn't work. It's because I didn't really believe in myself enough, and I didn't follow through. So, let's try this again. Maybe not. One more time. One more time. So what have we learned here? We've learned that the breaking wood over your head maybe isn't as easy as I originally thought, but maybe we tried a different piece of wood. It's kind of bent, but yeah. I did it. It only took like 20 or 30 tries, but the point is that I did it. I didn't give up. Even when my head was throbbing, I kept on with it. And that's the lesson for you here, is to not give up and to follow through with things.
Actually, I would say that the lesson is, if you want to cut a piece of wood in two, why not do it with a saw? That's kind of the lesson that I got from that clip.
I think the biggest motivation would be, if he dies from that, I'll be sure never to try that ever again.
Yeah, this is true. And why would he put it on YouTube? That man obviously has no shame.
Or he's making a lot of money. Maybe he's really more clever than we really thought.
Yeah, maybe it took him like, maybe that was his fifth take and he broke them all in the first one and nobody would have ever watched his video clip if he'd have ever.
Maybe he got a million hits off of that and he made a couple $1,000s on the ads.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he did, but.
Good video.
That was a funny one. Yeah, that was, if it had been a normal motivational video, I would have absolutely hated it. But you Americans, you can be pretty persistent, and you do love doing some bizarre things in front of a camera. And as we're going to have a look in our next clip, some parents do some rather strange things in cars with their children.
Say something crazy.
I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face. And then suddenly I bump into you.
I was thinking the same thing. Cause like, I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you.
But with you, I found my place.
I see your face. And it's nothing like I've ever known before. Love is an open door.
Finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me. Jinx again. Our mental synchronization can't have but one explanation.
You
and I
were
just meant to be.
I know you Americans have some very long car rides. I know some people, it can take you an hour to get to the shop sometime. So I guess you need to find some ways of entertaining yourself en route. But
the best part about that was the kid in the backside there. The little girl didn't care at all about what was going on.
I detected some embarrassment. Like, oh God, not my mother and father doing that again. It's just like, will you please shut up and just like look out of the window or something.
Oh man, shouldn't there be a law on doing that in a car? I mean, really?
I
could see they're going pretty fast.
Yeah, but you have these roads that are just, they're so boring. They just like stretch for miles and miles. No wonder you have cruise control.
Driving through Kansas.
Yeah, absolutely. It looks like one of those, you can see out the back that it looks like they're going through one of those flat, boring, square-shaped states where there's absolutely nothing for miles and miles.
Hey, I'm from Kansas. Don't talk like that about my country.
Well, you ain't in Kansas no more, Toto.
I'm in Pattaya. It's more fun here.
I'm not sure whether that's a fake. These two people look far too attractive to be normal Americans, because let's take it, yeah, most of you aren't the most attractive people in the world, so I think they're ringers, actually.
Do you have any dentists in the UK at all?
I knew when the teeth thing was going to come.
Oh.
I knew when the teeth thing was
going to
come.
What is going on with the teeth back in the UK?
Exactly. Well, not only, we're just more real in the UK. Let's have a look at something similar that the British did. This isn't actually a real one, it's from a BBC series of quite a long time ago, but it's kind of a British take on the same thing. So let's have a look at it.
So, what day is it today, Jasper?
Tuesday?
Wrong! It's NWA Day!
No, absolutely not.
It's alright, I've got it under control.
The police coming straight from the underground. A young chap's got it good, cause I'm brown. And not the other colour, so police think they have the authority to carry out inquiries. I don't mind, cause I ain't the one for an excellent policeman with a badge and a gun to be reasonably arresting and thrown in jail. We could go toe-to-toe in the middle of a sale, having lots of fun, cause I'm a teenager with a little bit of gold and a pager. Searching my car, looking for the biscuits, thinking every chap is selling bits of chocolate. You'd rather see me writing with a pen than me and Lorenzo rolling in a Benzo. Go swimming with Lorenzo. And when I finish, bring the yellow tape to tape off the scene of the sack race. Thank you very much for the bread and water. I don't know if they naughty or what. Such a chappy down and grabbing his hat. And on the other hand, without a hat they can't get none. But don't let it be a black and a white one, cause they'll tickle you until you're giggling. Black police having fun with a white cop. Ice Cube will entertain all the local bobbies in a blue uniform. Just cause I'm from the CPT. Nice police are nice
to me, huh? A young man in a hot bar.
And when I'm finished,
there's gonna be a party.
Of course,
having fun in LA.
Yo, Dre, I got something to say.
Help the police. Help, help, help the police. Help, help, help the police. Help, help, help the police.
And that, Jasper, is more or less the way it is in the hood.
Do you know the original of that?
Straight out of Compton.
Absolutely. I think, yeah, probably, if anybody watched that without ever having heard the original, they'd probably go, oh, what's funny about that then?
He wasn't bad.
You just have to, if you've never seen the original one before, there are rather a lot of swear words in the original version.
I know, I love NWA. They're just awesome. They brought us Ice Cube.
Yeah, who was the other ones in it?
Eazy-E.
Eazy-E.
And the other ones that we don't know about. Anybody else in it.
Yeah, there's whenever any super bands split up, you always end up one or two that go into obscurity. Which was the one who had one of them had this huge clock around his neck. He wasn't from NWA, was he?
Oh no, he's from Public Enemy. That's Flavor Flav.
Yeah.
And he's okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's all right. But his partner in Public Enemy, I forgot his name, but he's really good. He's such a strong rapper. Like that.
Yeah, and I'm not that into rap, I must admit. So, are really? You East Side or West Side man?
Because you look like such a homie, you know?
Yeah, I know. I'm
just, with a shaved head,
yeah,
and everything?
Yeah, gangster lean, that's the type.
So slick.
Chains, the jewelry. So, are you East Side or West Side?
Yo, we're East Coast, y'all.
You're down with Crips or the Bloods, man.
You know, my favorite was Beastie Boys, though, as far as rap groups go. But they were never fully accepted in the hip hop culture.
No, I was gonna say white guys. I don't think white guys can rap really. I think they.
But they are good.
Yeah, Vanilla Ice. Vanilla Ice.
Oh man, you know, I once got to meet MCA when I was in New York. It was really awesome.
Yeah.
I was just a naughty kid back in New York, and I was with a friend. We went to Tower Records.
Records existed back then? Yeah, in the old days where people used to buy music on discs, yeah.
It was so much fun. We could go in there and look at stuff.
Yeah.
But so they had long, 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 long magazine section.
Mm-hmm.
And they had some really dirty magazines there. Really dirty, straight, just straight weird ones. Plumpers, over 50, over 60. And then so, for a friend of mine, we just had nothing to do. This is before smartphones. So we used to take those magazines and bring them all the way to the front. Mix them up with the Time magazine and the Life magazine. And then we'd stand up on the stairs at the next level and just watch people. What is that? Just run across these horrible magazines.
I was wondering why Tower Records went bankrupt. I think you were probably partly responsible.
I know, I felt really bad about that because it could have been responsible. But that's when I met MCA.
All right.
He saw me doing that. And he said, what are you guys doing? Whoa, MCA!
So you got told off by a famous rapper for
no, he loved
juvenile
it. He said,
behavior.
He said, you guys are f***ing hilarious. You guys are sorry, Patia. That's what he said, though.
All right, we've got one last clip before we go, and we need to take this potty mouth man off TV. And it's been said that there is more technology in the average smartphone than there is in the computers that put man on the moon. And let's have a look at one of them in action, solving Rubik's Cube very, very quickly. Pretty impressive stuff from a phone, hey?
That's amazing.
It's amazing. And there's going to be more amazing stuff to look forward to tomorrow. So join us again, same time, same place, and we'll be back with some more ways of entertaining you. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Thank you, Patia.